I'm back with the sermon, a message from God to our hearts. And what I'm talking about is in sermon one before, I want to look at what we were talking about this morning, but also want to put another message onto this. One day as Jesus is standing by the lake of Gennesaret with the people crowding around him and listening to the word of God, which is the Sea of Galilee. He was standing around the Sea of Galilee with the people crowding around him listening to the word of God. He saw at the water's edge two boats left there by the fishermen who were washing their nets. He got into one of the boats and one belonging to Simon and asked him, "Put out the little from the shore." Then he sat down and taught the people from the boat. When he had finished speaking, he said to Simon, "Put out into the deep water and let down the nets for a catch." Simon answered, "Master, we've worked hard all night and haven't caught anything, but because you say, I will let down the nets." When they had done so, they caught such a large number of fish, and their nets began to break. So they singled their partners in the other boat to come and help them, and they came to fill their boats so full they began to sink. When Simon Peter saw this, he fell at Jesus' knees and said, "Go away from me, Lord, I am sinful man." For he and all his companions were astonished at the catch of the fish they had taken. And so were James and John and the sons of Zebedee and Simon's partner. Then Jesus said to Simon, and Jesus was saying, this is what Jesus was saying, "Do not be afraid. From now on you will catch men." So they pulled their boats up to the shore, left everything and followed him. And I want to just quickly go from there, from Luke 5 to verses 31. Jesus answered them, and this is what Jesus said, "It is not the healthy who need a doctor, but the sick. I have not come to call the righteous, but the sinners to repentance. So in Luke 5, verses 31, Jesus answered, "It is not the healthy who need a doctor, but the sick. I have not come to call the righteousness, but the sinners to repentance." Now getting back to Luke 5, from chapter 1 through to chapter 11, verses 11, from verses 1 to verses 11, Luke 5. When he had finished speaking, he said to Simon, "Put into the deep water and let down the nets to catch." I want to put this into a different context. And I want to put a different version of events on this from what was this morning. We're all going to have a different way of thinking and doing things. See, when he'd finished speaking, he said to Simon, "Put out into the deep water and let down the nets for the catch." Is this very similar? If we look at this, can this be very similar to this? John 4:35. You know the saying, 4 months between planting and harvest. But I say, wake up and look around. The fields are already ripe for harvest. Can we put the same context as what Jesus is saying here? Can we put the same context that when he had finished speaking and he said to Simon, "Put out into the deep water and let down the nets for the catch"? Can we see that Jesus Christ, God, his Father, Jesus already knew what was going to come up out of that catch? All these fish. But there is a parallel here. In this case, when finished speaking to the said to Simon, "Put out the deep water and let down the nets," isn't really Jesus saying to all of us that we need to go out and be fishers of men, to go out and catch men, women, to bring in the harvest for God? See, Jesus back then is talking about the fields are already ripe for harvest. See, in this, the disciples, in this we have here Simon and the other fishermen, they had already worked. They already had doubted themselves because they'd been working all day, all this time, and they had not caught anything. So they were doubting. But this man comes along, which is Jesus Christ. Jesus comes along and he says, because he's got all these people asking him questions. See, we see in verse 1, one day Jesus was standing in the lake of Gennesaret with the people crowding around him and listening to the word of God. So Jesus was talking about the word of God. Jesus was talking, and all these people wanted to press towards him, as they were saying this morning. They wanted to talk to him. He saw the water's edge to the boat, left there by the fishermen who were washing their nets. He got into one of the boats, and one belonging to Simon, and asked him, put out the little from the shore. Then he sat down and taught the people from the boat. So imagine on the shore of the water there, on the shore of the Sea of Galilee, all these people are flocking around the water, listening to this man sitting in the boat, talking about the word of God, and talking about what was happening. Now, while he was talking to the people about the word of God, he's obviously had this vision from God in his head and this test of faith to show everybody that if you believe and you have faith in God and your obedience to God and you do what the will of God says, then nothing's impossible in the sight of God. So when he had finished his speaking, he said to Simon, put into the deep water and let down the nets to catch. Simon answered his master, we've worked all night and haven't caught anything, but because you say so, I will let down the nets. Because Jesus said so, Simon had let down the nets. But they had been working all night. They had doubt in their minds. Doubting Thomas, they had doubt in their mind. And this is what we're talking about. The church is becoming cold as ice. We're not listening to Jesus Christ. We're not listening to the Word of God. We're not listening to God's will. We're not even listening to the Holy Spirit. So the church has become cold as ice. So what would have happened if we put this in reverse? What would have happened if Jesus was in the boat, out in the water, talking to the crowd of people, and this miracle of sorts didn't happen? Or Simon said, I won't obey you. See, Simon answered the master, we've worked all hard all night and I haven't caught anything, but because you say, I will let down the nets. See, it is allowing the will of God and it's allowing God's will to be done. And this is where it's saying in John 4:35, you know the saying, 4 months between planting and harvest, but I say, wake up and look around. The fields are already ripe for harvest. The fields are already ripe for harvest. We're not only talking about the fields being ripe for harvest, but there is a time for fishing. There's a time to go out and catch fish, and there's a time not to go out and fish. So the thing is at the end of the day, it's a matter of having faith in Jesus Christ and a matter of not fearing God. And if you do not fear God, then you can't fear the deep. You cannot fear the deep because your light shines. Your lamp, the light of your lamp shines for everyone to see. Because if you switch off the light, it's dark. You switch on the light again, it's light. So wherever there's light, there cannot be darkness. Wherever Jesus Christ is, and Jesus Christ is thriving, and Jesus is in your heart, there cannot be no darkness. But wherever you choose to hide your light, then darkness can creep in. And as Christians, we have to be vigilant, we have to be diligent, and we have to be obedient to God. But see, in verses, when Simon Peter saw this, he fell at Jesus' knees and said, go away from me, Lord, I'm a sinful man. And that's in verse 8 to Luke 5. Haven't we always said to God, Jesus, I'm not worthy, I'm not worthy of you. I am not worthy. Isn't that the same thing? Lord, I am a sinful man. Go away from me, Lord. I'm not worthy of you. I'm going to leave it there. We're all worthy of God. We're all God's sons and daughters. And Jesus loves you. He loves me. And as he says in Luke 5, verses 31 and 32. In 32 he says, I have not come to call the righteous, but the sinners to repentance. I have come to call for the sinners. Are you hearing God tonight? Are you